Style. So I hope you enjoy the video and I hope it relaxes. show you the dress that I've got on underneath this vest, because for one, I think it's really pretty, although not to everyone's taste, I will grant you that one. But it's also the material it's made out of, I think, is going to make some pretty cool sounds. But don't worry, I'm not doing a strip. Just the sound of the sequins, I think. across back down into town, back to the steps. This was like a few hours after I'd left the steps. And there it was. I found my necklace exactly where I was sitting a few hours before. Really surprised that someone hadn't nicked it. Because that's the thing. Stupid things like that. this room left over from when I had my startup company. So I'm probably going to use some of them to make some really cool sounds for you guys. Just for you. For you. For you. For you. Because I want to help you relax. That is my life's goal. Started watching other people's ASMR videos way back like 6 years ago. It really helped me with my insomnia, because if I haven't mentioned it before, I have like really bad insomnia sometimes. It's better now, thanks to a lot of things, which includes ASMR, has helped a lot. Among other things. So yeah, this is why I'm doing these videos now, is because I want to give back some of the help that I received. Very easy on the want to show you and manipulate in front of you in the theme of St. Patrick's Day. This is something that is called a crystal puzzle, 3D crystal puzzle, and this is a hobby that I have. I've got quite a few of them. videos in general, he made a video where he actually said that he showed up a makeup product, and he showed the little icon on it that shows its expiry date, and it's a little pot. The icon is a little pot, like a tub, a small tub, that has like a number on it and the letter M, which he told me that that number is actually the time that the product has before it goes out of date after opening it. And I had no idea of this. So thank you, Jeffree Star, for illuminating me. I didn't know. So most of my makeup, actually all of my makeup, is probably expired. I haven't bought new makeup in quite a while. Well, I bought a couple of lip glosses not too long ago, but other than that, almost the entire content of my makeup cases, which I have two of, are probably out of date. So I'm guessing that the same goes for nail polish. And as this nail polish in particular, I've had since I was a teenager, is probably out of date, and that's probably why it looks so messy, but it's the only green nail polish in the right shade that I had to go with this video, so I tried it anyway. I tried to thin it out a little bit with some dissolvent, the stuff that you use to take off nail polish, and it worked a little bit. It made it a little bit easier, but still not too good. So I'm just going to continue doing this tapping sound for a couple of minutes without any talking, so that you can enjoy it for a couple of minutes without me talking over. And then I'm going to pass on to the next object. Segment of the video, I'm actually remembering a funny story about this four leaf clover puzzle in particular. Is that when I was making it, I was getting really frustrated with it, and then after a while I finished it, and I was like, just so happy that the frustration was over, and I was over the moon. And so I put it down on my desk, and I was like, don't move, I need to go take a picture. So I moved to go and get puzzle off the desk, and it fell to the floor, and all the pieces just came apart. And my face reaction to that was literally for about 2 minutes, I think, after it fallen to the floor, was this. Seriously, I froze for like 2 minutes like that. I was just, what have I done? That was really, it wasn't funny on the spot. I was really mad. I was frustrated and I was mad that I had to do it all over again and that it was my fault for being so clumsy. But now I look back on it, it's funny because I managed to do it again. I need salad, Dave. It looks quite good. So, a last minute little add-on after the last segment that I just did, I thought it would be really cool to show you this. It's got nothing to do with St. Patrick's Day, it's still green. And it's this. So I was talking about it in the last segment of the video, and I just thought, okay, has nothing to do with St. Patrick's Day, apart from the fact that it's green. And I just thought it would be really cool to show you. So this is the Tinkerbell 3D crystal puzzle that I was talking about. And she's so pretty. I just think it really works, and in the packet they included some shiny stickers to go on the wings, which I think is a really good touch. So this isn't going to be a long segment because it wasn't actually planned in the video, and I've got some other things to show you, but I just want to take a couple of minutes to make a couple of sounds with it, because I think it's really cool. So please guys, let me know in the comments whether or not you would like to see a full whole video just of me showing and telling about my crystal puzzle collection. I'd like to make that video, so if you'd like to see it, let me know and I'll do it. this one doesn't look like a four-leaf clover, but it actually is. It's just that the way it was pressed, unfortunately, one of the leaves got stuck behind the other, and you can actually see that. You can see it a little bit on the camera. But yeah, these are real four-leaf clovers. I was actually really proud to have found some four-leaf clovers, because I was always under the impression that four-leaf clovers were really rare. And I actually thought that they were supposed to give you luck. Noting that I have found in the past numerous four-leaf clovers, like maybe 20, because they used to grow where I used to live. Representations of pieces of my life, past experiences, and bits of my own personality, and whatever you can call that, tattoos, symbolisms from my life, just anything. I love marking my body with my experiences and bits of my personality. So for the moment, I've got 5 tattoos. I have got this one. I've got that one, which is the Eye of Ra, and it represents royal protection and power. It's an Egyptian symbol, and it was my first ever tattoo that I got week I turned 18. And, but most foremost, it was just a representation of that passion that I have won for Egypt, because I'm really passionate about ancient Egypt and everything that goes around that. I watch a lot of Egyptian documentaries, and also it symbolizes my passion for tattoos, which started, it actually started way before I was 18, but I had to wait until I got, I was looking for the word, until I was came of age. Majority, I waited for my majority because my parents wouldn't allow me before that, and of course before that I would have needed their consent, so I waited until I was 18, and the week I turned 18 I'd planned the appointment for the tattoo, the week I turned 18, and I didn't do it on the day I turned 18 just because I had school that day, and I had to wait for the weekend. But yeah, the week I turned 18, on the weekend I was at the tattoo parlour getting my first tattoo. It actually felt like someone was slitting my wrist, but I've never regretted it, and I absolutely love this this tattoo that I've got. I love it, and also it's blue, favorite color. I've got this one, which the writing has gone a little bit, but it says immortality does not mean never dying. And again, that is obviously a reminder of my passion for Egypt. Also, the ankh was supposed to be yellow, and it was originally yellow, but the colour yellow does not stick very well, and it faded over the years. And that one is actually really, really symbolic for me. Not that I want to bring any depressing subjects to the table, but just to explain the tattoo. When I was in school, I had a teacher, which was our principal teacher, who dealt with like the class life and everything. And I had him in class for 2 years. And the year after I left that school, I was having a really bad time. I was actually very, very depressed. And one night I was out with my friends in a bar, just drinking and having fun, just trying to forget how depressed I was. And I came across another teacher from the, that school, and so I was a little bit tipsy, and I went up and chatted to the teacher, and I was like, you know, how's life at school going? How's it been since I've been gone? And that stuff, and he just, his face really decomposed, and he said, well, I guess you haven't heard. And I was like, heard what? And so he told me that that teacher that I'd had for 2 years took his own life, and that really affected me. I got this tattoo like over a year after that, and it took me even longer than that to get over that teacher I had had killed himself. So I got this tattoo. The meaning of it, basically, the ankh is the Egyptian symbol of life. They used to put these on the pharaohs or anyone who got mummified their sarcophagus to help the person being mummified go through afterlife. And immortality does not mean never dying, is my philosophical thought, that as long as a person is remembered, although they're gone from this world, as long as they're remembered, their soul stays alive. So it's basically my interpretation of the immortality of a soul, the soul's immortality. So moving on, that was a little bit depressing. Tattoo. I don't know if I can show it to you, but I'll try. Now, I don't know if you saw that. I'm gonna have to me when I was born, basically. So yeah, I've got a lower back tattoo, which is a tribal butterfly. And I got that for two reasons. First reason, because when I was growing up, I did not have any liberties. I'm not going to go into details, but I was really close-guarded, let's say that. I got this tattoo because it reminded me of the liberties, the freedom that I so desperately needed to flourish into the person that I was becoming. And so yeah, that's why I got that tattoo. And also, I can't lie, I also got the tattoo because at the time I was, I'd come out of my first love, basically the relationship in which I had my first big love. I'm not talking about crush, I'm talking about adult love. That was the first time I was adultly in love as an adult. And that person just happened to really like butterflies. So, you know, I was young and in love. Really important to me. And I've also got a fifth tattoo, which I won't go into detail about. I'm just gonna say it's a rabbit. I think it's pretty cool. You that the channel that I named in the beginning of the video, the link is down in the description. And down in the description you will also find my Facebook account that is solely reserved to this channel. So if you want to contact me for any reason, do it via the link below. I also really advise anyone who actually has an interest in my channel to follow me